Modern Winchester is an important city today, and it is interesting to learn that it was once much larger as a seat. Its boundaries extended beyond Hampshire and encompassed areas in Somerset, Wiltshire, Berkshire, Buckinghamshire and Oxfordshire. This carried on until the reign of Elizabeth I.
Winchester is a really popular tourist destination around the whole world. This is because as a city and as a seat, it is the home of masses of wonderful medieval architecture.
Much of the medieval architecture has been preserved really well because it's remained in a position of importance since 686, when it was made capital of Wessex.
We're here at the Hampshire Record Office to find out a little bit more about the Winchester pipe bronze. Some of the best resources for looking at the Winchester as a seat.
But where can the general public go to find out this information?
We're here with Bob Carter, who's a tourist visiting the remains of Wolfe Castle along with us. Firstly, where are you from, Bob?
From Wolfe.
So how much did you know about Wolfe Castle before you came here?
Nothing at all. I'm afraid I'd never even heard of it. So this is my first time in Winchester. I do like visiting, you know, for example, National Trust properties or English Heritage properties and having a look around. Both. I mean, I think it's very nice to have somewhere like this to visit, obviously very close to a sort of town centre. So it's a great kind of quiet atmosphere. It's, you know, it's a very relaxing place to come.
This is the Great Hall, which has been standing since the Norman times. William the Conqueror would have been here. Such an impressive structure really reiterates the power that Winchester had, the sustained power over a long, long period of time. This place was of utmost significance.
This meant that the royals would regularly stay in Winchester. On one memorable occasion, Edward I and his wife were nearly killed in a fire at this very location. On important trips such as this, the royals would have the option of staying in their own private residence or in such grand locations as the palaces of the bishops of Winchester.
We're standing in the remains of one of the most extravagant palaces of the whole of medieval England. The palace was built in 1138 by Henry of Poix and was of key significance in medieval Winchester and the whole of the country.
The royals were regular visitors to the palaces. Queen Mary and Philip II of Spain held their royal wedding breakfast here, which gives us the kind of idea of the grandeur that this place once held.
We're standing in the treasury at Wolsey. This is the treasury that would have been used for the whole of the See of Winchester. The amount of money that would have been stored here rivaled the monarchies even, and the pipe rolls that have made Winchester's archives so useful to us to look at the administrative aspects of Winchester would have been made in this very part of the building. Standing in Wolsey, you really get a feel for the immense power that the bishops had. It's a really impressive structure, and you can imagine how daunting it must have been for people when it was originally built.
The palaces were gradually built over a period of several bishops' time in office, and a constant renovation of them was a way for the bishops to demonstrate their wealth and power. As you can see from this, there are three distinct styles of architecture in just this one example of archway. In terms of politics and defence, this site was also extremely important. It was the site of the rout of Winchester in 1141, when the palace was besieged by Empress Matilda's half-brother. It was later restored by William of Wickham, and young people were educated here by Robert Langdon. The title of Bishop of Winchester was a highly esteemed one. Its status was so high because of the wealth of the see, and it usually signified a long and prosperous career. Some men who were Bishop of Winchester later went on to become papal legate.
The bishops Henry of Poix, Thomas Wolsey, and Henry Beaufort were all papal legates.
Henry of Blois was made papal legate in 1139, and when his brother, the king, Stephen, was elsewhere, he was arguably the most important role in England.
In 1427, Henry Beaufort committed to the Crusades against the Hussites in Europe. His central role within the Catholic Church resonated in England, and he is left behind, along with the other bishops, a really rich history for us to look at.
During the reign of Henry VIII, England infamously broke with Rome, meaning the role of papal legate became even more important. Cardinal Wolsey was made bishop in 1518, and was instrumental in setting up the Treaty of London, which maintained peace throughout the countries of Europe. In an increased time of tension, Wolsey was critical in maintaining Britain's power overseas. palaces of the bishops of Winchester were some of the most impressive buildings in the medieval period. The roles they took on included finger residence, holding an administrative significance, whilst also emphasising the religious aspect of Winchester. They also provided community support within the local area. Their grandness embodies what Winchester was at this time, an important part of the powerful country. However, what this period ultimately teaches us is that not even the power of the church can rival the might of the state.